Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today's Dollar Tree Christmas DIY project will be a part one of a 3D wooden gingerbread house with cookie tree and a wooden gingerbread wreath. And tomorrow will be part two. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to begin with five of these gingerbread wooden plaques from the Dollar Tree and two of the gingerbread houses. And I'm going to go in with some nutmeg paint from Apple Barrel. So I painted everything with that paint, and I had to add a little bit of the melted chocolate paint because I ran out of the nutmeg. And now I'm going to go in with some white chalk paint, and I'm going to fill in all the accent pieces, all of the arm accents and all of the leg accents. And I know the arm accents are probably sleeve cuffs. Not sure if the bottom ones are hems of pants or socks. I'm not really sure, but I'm just gonna go in and get it all painted, and also do the bow ties, paint them all white. And I like using this white chalk paint because it gives pretty good coverage. Usually one or two coats is all we need, so I'm pretty happy with that. So now I'm gonna go in with the same white paint and do all the window frames and the snowy roofs. And I'm trying to be careful to stay within the lines, because you guys all know this is like a real struggle for me. But you know what they say, practice, practice, practice. And with this project here, there's lots of opportunity for practice. So I just go in, try to take my time and get it all painted, get it all nice and covered. And I try to go slow around the edges, and then on the outside edges, then I just go for it, free for all. I'm not too worried about getting it on the paper, but I really don't want to get it on that brown painted area. I'd hate to go back and do touch-ups, but you know, if it happens, it happens, and I'll touch it up. But I'll just go in and continue to do this until I get all five of my gingerbread men painted with the accents, and also these two home plaques, these gingerbread houses, wooden plaques. Oh, and by the way, I did go in with some spackle, and I took care of all the little holes on all the gingerbread men and the houses. I didn't show that part, but I did do that. So the reason why I decided to do this is because I had put out a video about a month or maybe 2 months ago, about a month and a half ago. I put out a video on a gingerbread village, and let me tell you, it just blew up. People loved it. So I had some comments on there, and I actually had a couple people message me and they wanted more. So I said, okay, and you guys know me, I love gingerbread, so you don't have to twist my arm to do more. So I thought, okay, I'm going to do more. So, and I had these plaques that I picked up at the beginning of the season. So I just had them there, sitting there, and I thought, you know, I haven't done anything with these. Let me go ahead and work on these. And so now I've got this huge project, and it's pretty involved. So that's why I'm taking a couple of days of posting the videos to get it done. Otherwise, it would be about an hour video long. And yeah, I don't want to do that to you guys. That's too long, even though I speed it up quite a bit. Okay, so this portion here is the front of the house, and the other portion was the back of the house. The other portion only had one window. This portion has three windows, and so far no door, but it will have a door. So I'm just going to continue to paint this until I get it all done. And I'll also do like a snowbank for the bottom, just to give it that snowy look. And so I'll just keep working on this and get it done. So here I'm going to do the snowy banks, and I'm just going to add some snow on the bottom, and I'm going to leave a space in the center for the door, because you can't have a snowy bank on the door, you can't get in. So gotta have a little space there. And this is the back side of the house. And yes, this will be a 3D house. And yes, I already have a couple little mess ups. I'll have to go back and touch up here and there, but that won't be a problem. So now I decided to make this particular one into a little girl. And so I'm going to give her a little dress. And so I'm going to use this microfiber cloth from the automotive section of Dollar Tree. It's a real white and fluffy, really luxurious kind of fabric. So it's going to be her little top. And I don't know what I did with the footage where I actually cut it, but I thought I had pressed record, but I guess I didn't. But I do kind of put it back together and show you guys what I did. So first I outlined it with a Sharpie. So here I already cut it, but I went ahead and put it back together just to show you guys. So I had outlined it and I had cut it pieces out, and then I cut off the pieces for the arms and for the collar until I gave her like a little shirt. So see, those are the little arms, and so I just trace those real quick, cut those off, and then the little collar, trace that real quick, cut that off. So it was just a real quick little thing. Okay, so now I'm gonna glue this little shirt onto her. So I'll just add a little bit of glue and I'll press it down, and I'll add another bit of glue on the other side on her sleeve cuff, press that down. And this kind of fabric is really forgiving, because if you cut it a little bit too short somewhere, you could stretch it a little bit, and it's very workable. It's very easy to use. So I get her all pressed, and I was gonna do the bottom, but then I thought, no, wait a minute, I need to add her little skirt. So I'm taking this candy cane stripe fabric, and I'm gonna cut just a little square, or actually it's a rectangle. I'm gonna cut a little rectangle out to help make her little skirt. And I believe the measurement was 12 inches by 4 inches. So I have the fabric folded, so it looks like it's smaller than that, but I have it folded, and so I just cut off 4 inches or so. And so once you open it, you have a good 12 inch piece of fabric. And I'm going to glue the bottom part of it, which is the hem of her dress, and I'll fold it up, being careful. And I think my hand did touch the glue on this one, but I think my hands are now just red. They're just used to it by now. Oh goodness. So now her little dress is hemmed, and so I'm gonna begin making some little pleats. And I'm just doing it with hot glue. So I'll add a little dab of glue in the center, and I'll give a little pleat, make a little pleat, a little fold, and then add another little dab of glue and add another little fold. And I'll just keep doing this until I have her a little dress, and it'll look so cute. So just keep adding a little bead of glue and fold it. And then another bead of glue and then fold it. So I'm kind of trying to figure out the shape of it. I'm not using a pattern or anything. I'm just trying to figure out as I go. A lot of my DIYs are like that. I just, as I go, I'll see how it looks, and if I don't like it, I'll change it up. But I was pretty happy with the way it was looking. So I wasn't done, so I need to keep adding some more glue. And she's gonna look so cute when she's done. Oh my goodness. A little bit more glue, and this is so easy to do, so easy. And if you get pretty good fabric, you won't burn yourself, and you can always use your little spatula too, your little silicone spatula if you're worried about it. So a couple more. Looking so cute. I got glue on my mat. Alright, so here I snip off the excess, and I'll do one more on this side, just to make it look uniform. And I'll hold it down till it's dry. So now I'm ready to put her little skirt on. So I'll place it where I'd like, add some glue to her little belly, press her little skirt in. And here I forgot to close up the sides. I forgot to add glue and close up the sides, but I do go back and do that. So now I'm going to taper off her little shirt a little bit because it's a little bit too square. So I'll snip off a little bit on each end just to taper it a little bit. And so I'll add some more glue and put her little shirt down. So that way there's nothing poking out. So now that the front is done, I'm going to embellish her little shirt. So I've got this pom-pom ribbon from the Dollar Tree, and it's the Christmas colors, so it's perfect. So I'll place a little dab of glue, a little bead of glue, hold it down with my spatula, my silicone spatula. And I should have made the one end a little longer, and you'll see when I turn it over why. And I did the same thing with this one, but I made it work. It's just in hindsight I see, okay, I should have done that. Okay, so this one I think I cut this one long enough. So I'll add a little bit of glue, and this will be her little, like a little belt. You see how the ends are longer? So now I'm able to glue those ends to the back, and see how the sleeve ones are kind of short. So I kind of struggle a little bit to hold it down with glue, but I do get it. And this one on the bottom, oh, this one was so difficult too. Should have made it just a little tiny bit longer, but I sure didn't think about that, I guess, until later on. And sometimes that happens too when you're just working on a fly. So this side I got it long enough, so it worked out perfectly. Same with this one. As you can see, I'm saving the other sleeve for last. Oh my goodness. And I think I do end up touching the glue on this one too somewhere. Yeah. But I think my hands are so used to it now, so, you know, whatever. This one here is really a challenge. Oh, this one here was a challenge. But I got it. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and embellish her little collar of her little blouse. So I'm just going to add some glue and put the same pom-pom ribbon on there and kind of put it on a curve to kind of hug the neckline of her little blouse. And I'll just go up with the glue and use my little spatula so I don't burn my fingers, and get the little ribbon on there till it's dry, flip her over, and I'll secure those ends to the back. So I made these longer. See, I learn. Got them on there. So now I decided to give her a little headband, and this is more inspired by some of the gingerbread ornaments that I purchased from Amazon, that they didn't have any hair, the little girls. They just had like hair bows and headbands and things like that. So I decided to do a little headband. And so now with this extra little piece of red ribbon, I decided to fold it onto itself. And I'm going to create a tiny little bow. So I'm just gonna squish the centers in, and I'm going to use the same pom-pom ribbon that's pretty thin, and I'm going to snip off the excess, and I'm going to glue it tight on there so it'll create a bow. And I'm trying to be careful with this glue. I don't want to burn myself again. Not that I've ever burned myself badly, thank goodness, but I've come close. But I do know my limitations, so I do try to be careful. So here I'm adding some more glue just to finish off all the ends. I don't want anything peeking out. Hold it down with my spatula and put a little dab of glue on her headband and her little bow on her headband, and she's so cute. She's so cute. So now I'm going to finish off the little ends on her skirt that I should have done before I put her skirt on, but I guess I got a little overexcited. I wanted to see what it would look like with her skirt on that I didn't finish off these ends. So just put a little dab of glue and fold the edges down to give it a finished edge. And that's it. She's pretty much done. I just gotta give her a face, and that'll be later on. So she's done. All done. Super cute. Okay, so now I'm going to take 4 of these wooden planks from the Dollar Tree, and I'm going to paint them the same color, and also this little tree. Paint them all the same color. Once it's all dry, I'm going to take some of this tacky glue, and I'm going to take one of these full planks, and I'm going to add some tacky glue straight down, and I'm going to place the whole plank along the whole roof line. And I'm going to add a little bit of hot glue just to help keep it in place, like immediately. A little dab of glue on each end, but I'm going to let the tacky glue do most of the adhering. But I do add some to the back portion too. I do add some glue in a minute. So here I'm taking the other plank and I'm placing it on the other roof line. So at first I measure to make sure it's gonna fit just right. Add the glue, add a little dab of glue here, a little dab of glue there, and I place that on there. And I love these little planks. They fit the roof line perfectly. I mean perfectly. Add a little dab of glue to glue each plank together. And I'm amazed how well these two planks fit the roof line perfectly. I'm just amazed. Look at this. It's like perfect. It's like perfection. Perfect. It's looking cute. So now I'm gonna go in on the back side and just add some of this hot Gorilla Glue just for extra reinforcement and security. Let that dry. And now I'm gonna take another one of these planks, but it's a little bit too long, so I'm going to cut it to size, make a little pen mark where I need to cut it, and I'll use my little miter shears to kind of help score each side. And so I do the one side and then the opposite side, and then I'll flip it over and do the two sides again, and then I'll be able to just snap it off. It'll just snap off after I score it on each side with these miter shears. So once all this is done, all I have to do is just snap it off. It'll just snap off like a cracker. Like snap. One more time. But yeah, it just snaps off easy. See, look at that. Easy. So I just cut it with my EMT scissors. These are like EMT scissors that they use in emergencies, and the EMTs in the ambulances. Snip off your clothes, but they're great. And I don't remember where I got them, but I'm sure Amazon has them. I'm sure they do. So add some more of this tacky glue, and I'll add this little piece to the side of the house, and I'll reinforce it with some Gorilla hot glue as well. And now I'll work on the other side. And this time I'll just measure with the piece, the extra piece that I had, the remnant piece. And so I'll do the same process. I'll score one side, score the other side, flip it over. And I think on this one I couldn't see the line, so I had to make a little line on each side so I can see it better. And so score that. flip it over, score the other side, and then it'll just snap off like a cracker, like a graham cracker. So I'll do the same thing here, add some more of this tacky glue. This tacky glue works really well with wood. I was very surprised. Works really well with glue. Very close to like a wood glue. So I'll go ahead and add a little dab of glue on each end for immediate hold. And put my little plank on there. And once I get it stable, then I'll go ahead and add my glue. Add my glue on there. I think my girls are trying to talk to me. My phone keeps going off. Okay, so here, in case you guys are wondering what that noise was. Okay, so here I'm going to add the tacky glue to the frame of the house all the way down. And I'm going to add the other piece of the house, the back side of the house. So I'll just go down, go up, go down, and this is where it gets a little tricky. You gotta place it just right, otherwise you're gonna have a wobbly house. So just kind of place it on there, and thank goodness this glue is not as immediate as hot glue, so you have a little bit of time to finagle it and get it just right. So I place it on the table just to get it level and even. So I'm pretty happy with it. Well, this is the end of part one. Part two will be tomorrow, and part two we will decorate this house and we will work with the little gingerbread men and make them turn them into a wreath. So be sure to tune in tomorrow, and if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And please subscribe if you haven't, and click that notification bell so you don't miss tomorrow's video or any other future video. Like I mentioned earlier, I have tons of DIYs coming up this week for sure. And other things too. So until then, have a great day. Bye-bye.